DeepMind's new AI just made a breakthrough in math, improved the design of Google's chip it's running on, and casually optimized its own code, all without being explicitly trained for any of it. In fact, it simply evolved these skills. After a decade in chip design R&D and now building my own tech startup, this new AI agent caught my attention in the way few things do. In this video, I will break down exactly how it works and why this might be the most important AI for science yet. Over the past decade, AI has taken on some of the toughest problems in science, from protein folding to quantum physics, and even challenges in math and computer science. On this front, DeepMind has already built some very impressive models: AlphaFold, AlphaChip, and AlphaTensor, each designed to solve a particular task. And actually, I covered them all on the channel, so subscribe now to catch up later on and stay updated on what is next in technology. And just now, they've introduced something entirely new: AlphaEvolve. It's an AI agent that is not tackling specific problems, but discovering entirely new algorithms without any prior training for this. And that's a big deal. Now we are no longer using AI to solve specific tasks, but we are starting to build general agents that can explore large space and innovate on their own across many different domains. AlphaEvolve takes inspiration from the process of evolution, what's known as evolutionary algorithms. And to be fair, it's not something new. They've been around in machine learning for a while. Google's AutoML is a well-known example. These kind of algorithms are especially useful when the search space is huge, like when you're tuning a neural network or designing a computer chip where you're dealing with millions of variables and endless ways to combine them. What's really fascinating about AlphaEvolve is that it combines something old with something new: evolutionary algorithms with the state-of-the-art large language models. Think of it like this. It's an evolution on steroids, supercharged by LLMs. Now let's have a look at how it actually works, because this is super interesting. The process starts by giving AlphaEvolve two things: an evolution function and a code template. Think of this as the rules of the environment and the initial genetic blueprint. For example, if we're optimizing data center job scheduling, the evaluation function describes and scores how well each solution uses the data center capacity. Basically, here we define the scoring criteria and a basic starting point for the code, and from here, AlphaEvolve takes over. Then it enters so-called evolutionary loop, where it creates a large population of algorithms, basically a set of offspring for the problem. Inside this loop, AlphaEvolve uses a kind of a teamwork approach, where Gemini Flash generates a wide variety of algorithm variations, while Gemini Pro contributes fewer, more rare and high-quality suggestions. Next, each version is tested for how well it works. AlphaEvolve checks both correctness and performance, and then saves the result into the internal memory. This way, it learns from its mistakes. Just like nature, that keeps what works and discards what doesn't. And over time, it keeps improving the code. Then, only the best performing algorithms are used to create the next generation. And this loop keeps repeating, often millions of times, gradually evolving better and better solutions. Over time, brand new algorithms start to emerge. Just like in nature, where it takes many generations to evolve useful traits. Just think about how whales evolved from land to ocean creatures. This, by the way, took over 10 million years. Or how giraffes evolved these long necks. The real game changer here is that this evolution, this process, this natural selection is fully automated. So instead of waiting for years, we can now evolve and test new ideas multiple times a day. Just think about it. What used to take a research team in a lab years now can be tested in a matter of a few days by AlphaEvolve through this non-stop experimentation. And I was lucky to get an opportunity to talk about it with Pushmit Kalim, who is a vice president of research at Google DeepMind, and how it works and where all of this might be headed.
Yeah, so what is the most remarkable thing about AlphaEvolve is that it is not trained in it at all. In some sense, it essentially just leverages the baseline Gemini large language model. And what it does, it uses that model to orchestrate a whole evolutionary search system. So you start with a given problem. The model is told that you have to solve this particular problem. Here's a function evaluator. And this is the type of code that I want to, here's the skeleton of the code. And this is the part that you need to figure out or evolve. The model will then come up with different hypotheses as to how it solves, that it might solve the problem. And by evaluating those hypotheses, by combining them, by making changes to them, it is able to then develop a much, much better solution. So although the model itself is not trained, it is in some sense learning through that whole process. So we, like many people call it in context learning, where the model remains the same, but what is changing is the input that is going to the model.
What's really interesting, AlphaEvolve has already delivered some pretty cool results. On the scientific side, it's managed to speed up the matrix multiplication operation, which is the core operation behind the Google's Gemini model training itself. Matrix multiplication is one of the most important operations in the modern AI, which is running billions of times per second across every AI model every day. For decades, the gold standard has been Strassen algorithm, which has stood unbeaten since 1969. But AlphaEvolve managed to find a way to do matrix multiplication using one fewer step. This may sound as a tiny improvement, but eventually it led to about 1% speed up in Gemini's inference and training time. And when we're talking about such massive models, this results in millions of dollars saved and enough energy saved to power a city. And that's not it at all. AlphaEvolve also found a way to improve the circuit design and eventually the layout of the Google's TPU, the latest generation of Google Tensor Processing Unit, Gemini, and AlphaEvolve is running on this thing. Cool, huh? It managed to optimize a key arithmetic circuit inside the matrix multiplication unit by removing some unnecessary bits. And that's cool because this reduced both the chip area and power consumption. I'm just wondering why EDA tools didn't catch that. And it went even beyond that. It managed to optimize low-level GPU instructions at the compiler level, and this little tweak allowed to speed up by 30% the flash attention kernel, which is the key component in the transformer-based models. And this means even more saving in energy and compute. And it's so fascinating to see how AlphaEvolve manages to optimize basically the entire stack, from the software to low-level instructions to the circuits it's running on. On the commercial side, AlphaEvolve has discovered a new way to optimize Borg, which is Google's data center managing system. And according to Google, this single optimization led to about a 1% reduction in Google's cloud computing bill. Now, I found only the data from 2023, so this would be roughly 260 gigawatt hours, which is equivalent to a month of energy consumed in the whole San Jose. Now, my take on AlphaEvolve. As I spent more than half of my life in R&D, first as a software developer, full stack, and then 10 years in chip design, I know what it takes to develop something genuinely new. Not every human can do that, you know? So from this perspective, seeing how AlphaEvolve can autonomously discover sophisticated algorithms, frankly, incredible. And that's crazy because this is just the beginning, just the hint on what it can do in other industries and at larger scale. I would love to hear your thoughts on this in the comments. And just in case, I would really love an AlphaEvolve update on my cognitive, social, and humor functions. Now, one very important thing to keep in mind that AlphaEvolve isn't yet fully self-improving because it doesn't constantly upgrade its own core intelligence or learning algorithms in this direct self-feeding loop. For that kind of improvement that we see with Google Gemini releases, these take months and a lot of human input, and this process isn't fully automated, at least not yet. AlphaEvolve comes not without limitations. At the moment, it can only take on problems which solutions can be evaluated with a score function. Which means if the system cannot understand what a better solution looks like, AlphaEvolve can't evolve towards it. Another consideration that this approach actually works the best with models which can handle large context, because we need this context for the model to learn, to remember what it tried before, and to learn from its mistakes. The funny thing is, we humans are not so different from AI. We are also constantly chasing energy, right? In different forms. And we're also constantly trying to improve our functions, our code, our cognitive and social functions. And we are learning from mistakes, from trials, just like AlphaEvolve. But in our case, we call it life experience. Now, looking at the bigger picture, and I got this opportunity to look at the bigger picture because I'm just back from Google I/O, which was incredible experience. So looking at the bigger picture, it really drove home this idea that AI isn't just the next big thing. It will be definitely bigger than the internet. And seeing all the progress with large language models, image and video generation, for me, still applying AI to science is the most compelling, the most exciting part of it. And seeing all this amazing research Google DeepMind is doing, it makes me wonder, how do they choose the next big scientific challenge to tackle?
So I think for us, the most there are a few different dimensions that a few different considerations that we think about when we do problem selection. One being the impact of the problem, whether that problem is transformative enough in the sense that it's a root node problem, which if you can somehow solve it, then it brings about a paradigm change or a transformative change in it, in our abilities to solve many more problems, downstream problems. So that's one element. Second sort of requirement is that the problem needs to require AI. Right, that there is it's a hard problem where we think AI can have a transformative difference. And thirdly, in order for AI to make this difference, it cannot just happen in a vacuum. It needs experience. So the presence of training data is extremely important as well. Like whether we have the right training data or the right evaluation methodology for us to make progress on that. So if you look at all the different AI models that we have generated for science, whether it's AlphaFold, whether it's some of our genomics work or some of our fusion work, and even now our maths models or AlphaEvolve, they have training data or this evaluation.
I'm definitely looking forward to see how AlphaEvolve will impact scientific discovery. And I'm particularly excited that this episode is sponsored by 80,000 Hours. They are an incredible non-profit organization that helps people find careers where they can truly make a difference in the world. They are called 80,000 Hours because you spent roughly 80,000 hours of your life working. This is 40 hours a week, for 50 weeks, for 40 years. And that's a lot of time. And if you want to make the world a better place and make a difference, this is your biggest opportunity. 80,000 Hours is a nonprofit that helps you find a fulfilling career where you can make a big impact. Their advice, don't just follow your passion. In fact, 80,000 hours spent the last 10 years researching how to do work that truly matters. And now they've built an amazing set of resources, including guides on how to build a high-impact career, one-on-one career advising, and a curated job board with roles they believe are especially impactful. They even run a podcast with in-depth interviews with experts about the world's most pressing problems. And the best part, all of these resources are completely free. Their only goal is to help you make a difference. So now go to 80,000hours.org/Anastasia to get your free career guide. Check them out, and thank you, 80,000 Hours, for sponsoring this episode. I truly admire your work. And thank you guys for watching till the end. I will see you in the next episode. Very interesting one. Ciao.